Hello, everybody. Welcome to 7 Days to Die, a game that you guys request a ton, honestly. You guys request this game so often, and it's a game I've been meaning to get back to. 7 Days to Die, for the simply explained, if you don't know what it is a good solid mix of zombie survival and Minecraft. Kind of like that crafting open world thing. It's a voxel-based game, so the terrain is destructible, the buildings are destructible, and even obey some sort of gravity, so the buildings come apart. But it's all about surviving as long as you can. And there are the single player options and the multiplayer options. Now for the series, I'm going to be doing single player for the time being, though I think I will end up dabbling into the multiplayer servers here and there just to check it out. But I haven't played 7 Days to Die since Alpha 1, and we are now on Alpha 9, much longer along the road. So there's a lot of stuff that I haven't been able to experience or see. And if you want, I did do Alpha 1 videos. I think it was 3 episodes. So you can go back and check that out. We'll see how this game has come along. I'm actually really excited because I think 7 Days to Die has a very promising idea behind it. Kind of taking that survival-ish game type and adding that craftable, Minecraft-y experience into it. And I am... It just has a lot of promise to it. For some reason, I am bumbling over my words, and I apologize. Hopefully, you get what I mean. So let's go ahead and start a new game, and we'll start. So a couple of things have been changed. One, we can do single player, multiplayer, all that good stuff. I apologize about that. So we can do single player. Second, there are two different options. We can do the Navez game, which is the typical map that I played on before. Or we could do random world gen, which is what we're going to do because they have now random world generation. That's something I've never been able to use before. Also, some gameplay stuff. There's a little bit of customizability here. The 24-hour cycle, percentage of night, which is, I don't even know what that means. Block dirt, well, they just have a percentage of 50% means equal day. Okay, so it's basically 35% of a day is going to be nighttime. Block durability, the hardness of each block in the world could be modified here. Interesting. We'll leave that there. Craft timer. Normal amount of time, that's fine. Loot timer, every so often, how often loot respawns. Open loot container. So this is how quickly it is to open loot container. We'll leave it there. There are airdrops in the game now, which is interesting. We'll do one a day. And then miscellaneous is cheat mode, which we're not going to really bother with. Again, a lot of this, even this loot drop thing is a little bit of rust involved. Kind of cool. I can dig it. Let's go restore defaults. I don't know why it's... stuck down here. This could be a little bit of a bug. It's like stuck down here, but we'll leave that there. There's other things that we could modify. So we're gonna actually go back. New game. Oh, what the hell, man? Ah, it's stuck. Lame. There we go. Can we mess with things? It really is stuck. That is unfortunate. I can't see Jack Diddley. Other things we can mess with, by the way, are just like zombies, how many there are, loot rarity, and all that good stuff. We're going to leave everything as it is and just explore the game a bit. So let's go ahead and hit start. It is, oops, almost forgot to put random world gen on. And we'll go ahead and hit start and play. All right, and here we are. Okay, well, this is an interesting start. So your typical rules apply. The bottom left, you got your health, your stamina, your food, and your drink. Because this is a randomly generated world, I don't know where we are. So we'll see what we can do and see how well we can end up surviving in the meantime. Is this a stone? The mouse sensitivity is a little bit much. We're actually going to mess with that if I can't even touch options. Really? All right. Well, I guess we'll do that before the next play. Search bird nest. Interesting. It's got to be probably like presumably like eggs and stuff can spawn in there. So if we hit M, we can take a look at our map. And this is, I don't know what this is. We can drop down waypoints and stuff. If there are friends and stuff, we can actually track them and friend meet up with them. Again, things for multiplayer. This game definitely did a large focus to multiplayer, as you can see. Our inventory here, we have a whole crafting screen that wasn't there before. Our character, we have like equipment slots. The game just looks a little bit sleeker and a lot better than it did before. So I'm here walking around. I'm not entirely sure why. So let's just move. Let's start looking around for a place we can call home. That's a big part of it, is just building up a base and being able to live through it. Obviously, the game isn't the best-looking game in the world. It is voxel-based, so that is kind of part of it. Ah, there's a zombie over there. That's what I heard walking. And we got some wildlife over here, which we can't really mess with. Interesting zone. I don't really know what the heck's going on. It just sounds like a bunch of zombies. I don't know if that I like that I spawned in Winter Zone. That just is problematic. So if we could just get the fuck out of here. Hopefully they won't really bother us. We don't have a weapon or anything. And I don't know how to craft anything quite yet. Just picking up stones, because I'm pretty sure I can make some stone tools at least. You know, your typical make a stone axe, make a stone pickaxe kind of thing. Which we're definitely going to need those, so we can get some wood and other minerals later. There are special zombie types too, that is important to note. I don't have any sticks actually, so I need sticks. And I don't know how to get sticks. Survival is going to be tough for me because it's been so long since I've played this game. I don't know if there's anything I can even do. Can I just punch trees? Like, is that something I can do? I'm afraid a zombie's going to pop up around the corner. Can I just not loot this? I wish I could just, like, loot sticks. I'm just picking up rocks for now. I have a feeling they'll be useful. Let's see if we can get the hell out of Dodge. I can hear them walking around. One of the cool things is that the clutter in this game is pretty decent and that zombies are really hard to see. And in a first-person zombie survival game, making zombies kind of difficult to track and see can really add to the difficulty into the game. So I'm down with that. What do we got over here? Garbage pile. More bullet casings. What was that? Was that an airdrop that I missed? Stuck in the wild in the middle of winter. And I might have missed an airdrop. Cloth fragment. I'm sure that could be useful at some point. Another bird's nest. If we can get eggs or something, that could be good food. What the fuck? Okay, first of all. Hold up, lady. Oh, you're a nurse. I thought you were wearing a bathing suit. I'm like, why are you wearing a bathing suit way out here? So, the way this game works is during the day, zombies are your typical walkers. Nighttime is when things get a little bit more dangerous. At night, or particularly just in the shade, at least it used to be, zombies get super fast and super strong. And one of the things I didn't like about the game, and I'm sure it's still the same way, is that at night, zombies kind of just knew where you were, and it was like a horde mode survival kind of game. Not a huge fan of that, I'm not going to lie. But we'll learn to play with it, because I do like, again, generally the idea of the game. And sound off in the comments, do you guys want to see more single player of this game or multiplayer? Because I will accommodate. Joining a multiplayer server is actually very, very easy and something I can do with a great amount of ease. So I would happily join a multiplayer server if you prefer that. What was that? Holy shit, you probably saw my camera go. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. What was that? Really? It was you? You were just that close? So we can punch some zombies. Some zombie face. I hear another weird, like, zombie thing going on. Plague nurse. Let's see what she had. She had some pills. So it looks like they have loot equivalent to what they are. So if they're a nurse, they'll have, like, some other stuff. Alright, well, we're actually going to cross out of the winter biome. Which is good for me. As of right now, I'm not looking too hot. Mainly because... Alright. It's a sharp change in biome there. Cannot breathe underwater, no shit. Can I not? Okay, there we go. Well, it's nicer over here. Alright, let's take a look at our inventory. Can I just, like, learn this? Alright, enough with the screaming. So as you can see, since it is voxel-based, the game does kind of load as you approach. Though it does have a decent loading distance. I'm going to see if I can crank that up, maybe. I don't know if it's possible to, but I'm going to try and crank that up between the episodes. What the balls is going on? I need sticks, man. I don't think I can hit people with rocks. I wonder if I can equip a rock. Also, a big problem, it seems, is that zombies, okay, they actually do chase wildlife, it looks like. Ooh, there's buildings over there. Zombies seem to just sound like they're a lot closer than they are. Let's just move. Hey, piggy. Don't worry about me, bro. Just coming through. A flower. I'm sure that'll be useful. This looks like a barren wasteland. That's screeching. Presumably would just cause noise and draw zombies to me. So what... Let's equip a rock. Let's see if I can actually do anything with a rock. Okay, throw rocks. That's useful. What'd I pick up? Please tell me I picked up like a stick or something. No, they're chasing some wildlife. There's like clicking going on. So over here, I wonder if like some driftwood will pop up on here. Let's take a look at the map too. What the fuck? Wow, there's a lot over there. Is that a bloatfly? Like from Fallout? Are you gonna attack me? Hi, you are. You are gonna attack me. Oh, you're huge. What zombie wasteland is this garbage? Get me out of there. No thank you, sir. I would not like to participate in your games. I'll definitely take that, though. Can you please leave me alone? This is not the zombie apocalypse that I'm used to. AKA big fucking bugs. I just want a building. If I can find a building, I can loot it and secure it. And maybe use it as like a base of operations. Are you kidding me right now, you dumb bug? Do you never de-aggro? There's a lot. I wonder if they just live in that biome over there. I'll just stick in this biome then. Deer, go attract the zombies, man. That's gonna be your job. So can I do anything? Aged wood. Can I do anything? Cinder blocks. Rocks. Craft. I don't know what that is. Scrap lead, scrap iron. Tools? I don't want to get scrap. I need to find a place that I can consider safe and mess around with the crafting a little bit. I don't know what he's swinging at. Doesn't look like it's going to be very useful. Not going to lie. Probably not going to help him out too much. Let's just keep moving. Why does it sound like there's so many screaming zombies? You need to relax. Nobody wants a screaming zombie party. No one asked for it. Nobody wants it. Look, relax. I know things are really exciting to see like live meat walking around, but I personally am not very tasty. Not a lot of meat on my bones. I'm relatively kind of unhealthy looking, just generally speaking, not so hot. Abandoned rubbish. Well, if it's rubbish, typically it would be abandoned. So my food situation is not bad. Water, as far as I know, can be infected, so drinking straight out of ponds and shit can be dangerous. Alright, let's pop this open. I think we're safe. So this is like cloth garbage. I just want tools, man. Metal strips, wood plank. Craft. Okay, so we're getting some wood planks. I'm hearing walking. I'm not sure what it is, but I'm hearing it. Okay. Let's continue. I would like... Okay. Sharp stone. I can hear more walking, but I want tools. This is a build and run kind of game. She's a decent distance away, though. We'll go ahead and move and put some more distance between me and her. Okay. Sticks. Is that something we can do? We'll get a stick. I would like to make... What's a gavel do? Sure, give me some gavel. Not gonna lie. That looks like it's gonna take fucking forever, but hey, I can do that at least. I made some gavels, guys. Okay. Like, where are the tools? Maybe I need some plant fibers? Barbed club. There's a lot of stuff. Like a wooden club? Sticks. Lots and lots of sticks. So... Alright, we're gonna make... some sticks so we can make a wooden club. That should be enough. So if I want a wood, not a spiked club, just a wooden effing club. Thank God. We'll have some sort of weapon. Okay. I don't want to try this on anyone. I just want to move and, like, find a fucking house. Is that you that's screaming a lot? You're kind of ugly. Oh, is this gonna... You are. Combat is a little bit janky. Spider zombie. Do you just, like, call in little babies or something? I have no idea if this is doing anything. It is actually deteriorating my actual club. Alright. I think best bet is find some fucking high ground. Find high ground, and we can do something with it. Maybe we can see some buildings. Nothing. Lots and lots of nature in this random map. This makes me sad, because I don't know where to go. At least in the crafted map. At least there was like a city zone and stuff. I do like that the zombies do kind of wander after wildlife, though the wildlife doesn't seem too intelligent. And we're at an area that is like a gigantic effing ocean. Okay. Well, we have a wooden club, guys, and you couldn't really be much happier about that. Whoa. All right. Just let me live my life in peace. Can this just be peaceful zombie simulator? I feel like that'd go over a little bit better with me. Hello. Could you not? Thank you. What is that? Is that just more water? It looks like a flat piece of land. That's why I'm curious. Wait, is this like a road? Okay, so we're back on a road. Flu epidemic. That's all it was, guys. Is this a big misunderstanding, everybody? All you have is the flu. It's okay. You can come out from wanting to eat the flesh of living beings. It's just you don't actually want it. You have a flu. Look, the newspaper says so. Nuclear. Okay, well. Listen. Okay, one of the newspapers said it, okay? And, I mean, newspapers don't lie, right? The press, the media, they don't lie. Why, okay, alright, I'm sorry, you don't have the flu, you can be whatever you want, I don't care. If you want to be a tap dancing doctor pilot, that's fine. Dude, you look a little bit naked. Like, just a little naked. And you're missing, oh no, you have some tighty whities on. That's kind of cute. Ow. I am bleeding out, use the bandage. Naked walker. I'm gonna guess he doesn't have anything. Lead fishing weights. Well, I was wrong. I'm bleeding out. Good to know. What is this? Bandages. So we can just go ahead and click bandages, and do we just use them? Alright, I'm healing up, everybody. Don't worry about it. Everything's gonna be okay. Probably. Are you guys going for a walk? Like, where are we going? Are you gonna lead me to a house? You guys are pretty deadlocked on that deer, huh? Nature is a beautiful thing. Alright, chill out. Hey, buddy. What's going on? Okay, see ya. Welp, civilization is not something that is readily available, it seems, but at least our first foray back into 7 Days to Die is a productive one, aka a wooden club. We'll be back tomorrow with some more 7 Days to Die for a while. I don't think this will be a long-running series, but it'll definitely be a little one that I get to explore the game a little bit more of. It has been such a very long time. I like how I saw that bunny spawn and plopped onto the ground. Let me know, you guys, with a new series like this, as always with any new series, your support's welcome, and typically with the first few episodes, I like to read the comments and see if you guys are enjoying it or not. So if you are, let me know. If you're not, let me know. And if you'd rather... sorry. He's out of breath. That scared me. And if you'd rather see multiplayer, also let me know. And hopefully next episode, we'll get ourselves a little bit of civilization. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.